Hello mga ka-wisdom! Welcome to Wisdom is Power Channel. Kung bago ka pa lang sa channel na ito, huwag kalimutang mag-subscribe, i-like, mag-comment at i-share ang video ito. Click mo na rin ang notification bell to receive more wisdom videos na katulad nito. Salamat! Ngayon pag-uusapan natin about Cramer's Rule. Cramer's rule is a method for solving systems of equations that have the same number of equations as variables. In this method, the values of the variables in the system are to be calculated using the determinants of matrices. Consider a system of linear equations with n variables, x sub 1, x sub 2, x sub 3, and x sub n. So ito yung mga variables natin, no? Can be written in the matrix form A multiplied by X is equals to B. Where A is the coefficient matrix, it should be or it must be a square matrix. And X is the column matrix with variables. And B is the column matrix with the constants, which are on the right side of the equations. So X sub 1, ito yung ating mga variables. Kung paano natin isosolve yung mga variables sa ating linear equations. Halimbawa, meron tayong system of linear equations na merong tatlong variables. So halimbawa, x sub 1. Ang formula for Cramer's rule is d sub x 1 over d. Itong mga d x sub 1 na to, ito yung determinants ng matrix na merong variable x divided by d, where d is the matrix of A or the coefficient matrix, which is not equal to 0. X sub 2 is you divide the determinant of matrix with variable 2 over the coefficient matrix, and so on. So kung ilan man yung variables na yon, ang equation lagi natin, kukunin natin yung determinant ng matrix na mayroong variable. Say, for example, x, divided natin sa determinant ng ating coefficient matrix. So, for a system with three variables, construct four matrices. So, kung tatlo yung ating variables, dapat meron tayong apat na matrices, no? So, that is, yung matrix natin is equals to n plus 1. Kung ilang yung variable, plus 1 dapat. So the first matrix, or what we call the coefficient matrix, will have elements from the coefficient of the variables. Then the other three are column matrices obtained by replacing the corresponding column in the square coefficient matrix with the identified column vector, or yung constants natin. So let's have a practice problem here. So meron tayo ditong tatlong equations. Actually, galing ito doon sa discussion natin about nodal analysis na ginamitan din natin ng Cramer's rule. So, isinama ko na rin yung link sa baba para ma-review mo kung paano nag-arrive dito sa tatlong equations na to. Okay. So, let us assume na nakakuha na tayo ng equation, nakapag-gawa na tayo ng equation, na-develop na natin yung equation, tatlong equations. So, we will try to solve yung mga value ng variables using Cramer's rule. So sabi ni Cramer sa Cramer's rule, ang una nating matrix, yung coefficient matrix. Ibig sabihin, gagawa tayo ng matrix, galing ang elements, galing dun sa mga coefficients ng ating mga variables. Katulad nung first equation natin, mga coefficients natin, 3, negative 2, negative 1. So, ito yon the first row. Then, equation 2, meron tayong mga coefficient na 4, negative 7, and plus 1. So, that is 4, negative 7, 1. Then, equation 3 is 2, negative 3, and positive 1. So, ito yung ating coefficient matrix. Then, we have also the yung variable matrix natin. Ano? So, vector, column vector siya. So, 3BA minus 2BB minus BC equals 12. Okay? So, 4BA minus 7BB, 1BC. Then, 2BA minus 3BB plus BC. So that is equals to yung ating constant. So naka-column vector din siya, no? Ito yung ating mga constant. Then, gagawin na natin yung Cramer's rule. So, para magawa yon, so assuming kinuha na natin yung coefficient matrix, tawagin natin E matrix o matrix E. Then, sabi dito, kung kukunin natin yung determinants, gagamit tayo ng basket method, ano? So, kung nalimutan mo na kung paano ginagawa yung basket method, sinama ko rin sa baba yung link para ma-review mo yung determinants of matrices natin. So, yung kukunin natin yung determinants ng ating matrix E. So, ang gagawin natin, so lahat daw ng diagonal downward, that is 3 times negative 7 times 1 sum of products, that is 3 times negative 1 times 7, plus yung negative 2 times 1 times 2, plus negative 1 times 4 times negative 3. So lahat yan ang pababa. Then isusubtract naman natin yung diagonal upward, no? So that will be 2 times negative 7 times negative 1 plus negative 3 times 1 times 3 plus 1 times 4 times negative 2. So simplifying, so lahat ng pula isi-simplify natin. So that will become negative 21 plus negative 4 plus 12 minus yung mga blue. That will be positive 14, negative 9, and negative 8. So simplifying more, so we will get negative 13 minus negative 3, and we will get the determinant of E, which is equals to negative 10. Next, kukunin naman natin yung matrix ng bawat may variables. So, halimbawa, ito. Itong column na to ay para sa variables ng VA or the voltage across node A. So, papalitan natin yan noong mga constant, no? Na 1200. So, yun ang ipapalit natin. So, yung column na 342, napalitan na natin ng 1200 galing dun sa constant. Then we will proceed sa basket method, no? Uulitin lang natin yung dalawang column. Then sum of products, lahat ng diagonal downward, no? That is 12 times negative 7 times 1 plus negative 2 times 1 times 0 plus negative 1 times 0 times negative 3. Then yun namang upward diagonals, 0 times negative 7 times negative 1 plus negative 3 times 1 times 12 plus times 1 times 0 times negative 2. Simplifying again, we will get negative 84 para sa mga reds, at para sa naman sa mga blue, we get negative 36. So then negative 84 minus negative 36, it will become the determinants of matrix A is equals to negative 48. Next, yung kasunod naman, yung variables natin para sa VB. Papalitan uli natin ng mga constant, no? So, 1200. Dito naman siya popesto sa second column. So, the same process, basket method. So, sum of products ng mga diagonal downwards. So, 3 times 0 times 1 plus 12 times 1 times 2 plus negative 1 times 4 times 0. Then, subtract mo yung diagonal upward. That is 2 times 0 times negative 1 plus 0 times 1 times negative, positive 3, I mean, plus 1 times 4 times 12. Yung mga reds, simplify, that is 0 plus 24 plus 0, minus yung mga blue values, that is plus 48, simplifying the matrix nung ating determinant of matrix B is equals to negative 24. Punta na tayo doon sa column ng variable VC. So ito naman ang papalitan natin ng ating constant. So magiging ganito siya. So uulitin lang yun natin yung first two columns, then we will proceed now to basket method, the sum of products ng mga diagonal downward. So that is 3 times negative 7 times 0 plus negative 2 times 0 times 2 plus 12 times 4 times negative 3 minus diagonal upward 2 times negative 7 times 12 plus negative 3 times 0 times 3 plus 0 times 4 times negative 2. Simplify. We will get a value of negative 144 for the reds. Then, para sa mga kulay blue, we will get negative 168. So then, simplify, negative 144 minus negative 168, and we will get 24 for the determinants of C. Then, magpuproceed na tayo dun sa ating equation. Kung ano yung variables na hinahanap natin, that is equals to matrix nung determinants ng matrix na may variable A divided by the coefficient matrix. That is equals to negative 48 divided by negative 10. And we will get 4.8 volts. Para sa BB, determinants of B divided by the determinants ng ating coefficient matrix. So we will get 2.4 volts. Para sa voltage C, determinant ng matrix C divided by the determinant of coefficient matrix, and we will get negative 2.4 volts. Okay, so for practice problem number 2, using Cramer's rule, solve the system with 3 variables. So ito yung ating mga variables, yung X and Y and Z. So color-coded, you know, red is X, green is Y, and blue is Z. So again, kukunin natin yung ating coefficient matrix, no? So lahat ng ating coefficient ng ating mga variables, tawagin natin siyang matrix C. Then yung ating column vector para sa mga variables equals natin sa constants. Then solving for the determinants ng ating C, no? Pero i-identify muna natin yung mga matrices ng ating mga variables. So that is, so ito yon para sa papalitan natin ng constant. So tawagin natin siyang matrix X. Pagdating naman dun sa variable Y, so papalitan natin yung second column ng ating constant. Okay, so negative 5, 4, 7, tawagin natin siyang Y matrix. Pagdating sa column ng ating third column, okay, yung variables ng Z, ito yon, papalitan natin ang ating constant ng negative 5, 4, negative 7, tatawagin natin siyang matrix Z. Then, kukunin natin yung determinant ng bawat matrix natin, yung C, yung X, and Y, and Z. So using the basket method again, so lahat ng up, ng downward, I mean, downward, 1 times 1 times 7, plus 2 times negative 3 times negative 3, plus 3 times 3 times 4. Then, ma-minus naman natin yung lahat ng upward, no? That is negative 3 times 1 times 3, 4 times negative 3 times 1, plus 7 times 3 times 2. Then simplifying, lahat ng pula, 7 plus 18 plus 36, lahat ng blue, negative 9, negative 12 plus 42. Then 61 minus 21, and we will get the determinant of matrix C is equals to 40. Then the process will continue para sa pagkuha ng determinant ng X. So, ang makukuha natin dyan, negative 40. So, gamitan na lang natin ng basket method ulit. So, dx over dc, that is equals to, the value of x is equals to negative 1. For the value of y, we get y is equals to 1. At ang determinant nun si is equals to negative 80. So, substitute natin sa ating equation and we will get the value of z, which is equals to negative 2. So, ang value ng ating mga variables, x is equals to negative 1, y is equals to 1, and z is equals to negative 2. So, to check, substitute natin yung x, y, and z dun sa ating equation 1. So, that will become negative 1 plus 2 times 1 plus 3 times negative 2 is equals to negative 5. Then, negative 5 is equals to negative 5. So, check para sa equation 1. Para sa equation 2, so sa substitute uli natin yung mga values nating nakuha. So, 4 is equals to 4. So, that is another check. For equation 3, sa substitute uli natin yung ating mga values. So, that is equals to negative 7 equals to negative 7. So, tama yung mga values natin na nakuha. For practice problem number 3, the cost of 4 kilogram onions, 3 kilogram wheat, and 2 kilogram rice is 60 rupees. The cost of 2 kilograms onion, 4 kilograms wheat, and 6 kilogram rice is 90 rupees. The cost of 6 kilogram onion, 2 kilogram wheat, and 3 kilogram rice is 70 rupees. Find the cost of each item per kilogram by Cramer's rule. So, kung ilalagay natin sa matrix yan, so that is 4, 3, 2, yung ating mga variables for the first equation. Para sa ating second equation, we will use the 2 kilogram, 4 kilogram, and 6 kilogram. Para sa ating third equation, gagamitan natin ng 6 kilogram yung onion, 2 kilogram yung wheat, and 3 kilogram yung rice. So yung O natin ng mga variables dito, yung column ng ating variables is O para sa onion, W para sa wheat, and R is for rice. So ito yung ating mga constant, yung 60 yung kanilang mga price. So 60, 90, and 70. Kung isusolve natin siya using Cramer's rule, makukuha nating value for the onion price is 5 rupees, para sa wheat ay 8 rupees, and R yung sa rice ay 8 rupees. So that's all mga ka-wisdom. Again, kung bago ka pa lang sa channel na ito, huwag kalimutang mag-subscribe, i-like, mag-comment at i-share ang video ito. Click mo na rin ang notification bell to receive more wisdom videos na katulad nito. Thank you at kita-kits sa next wisdom video.